friends, I'm back, and in today's video, we are going to be talking about ways to keep your internal motivation really, really high so that you can achieve all the goals that you've set for yourself for 2019. So stick around and let's chat about Brendon Burchard's high performance habit number 3, raising necessity. So, my name is Ange. For those of you who are new to my channel, thanks for stopping by. And for those of you who are back for the third installment of Brendon Burchard's High Performance Planner Weekly Review Checklist, thanks for coming back. I'm really excited to share this week's topic. So, as we kind of have noticed with some of the top performing people in the world, it seems that they are able to find a motivation to grind and hustle and work towards their goals day after day after day. And even when things are going wrong and they have been defeated or turned down or rejected, they continue to persist. So the reason that those people are so successful is because they have this internal drive and this internal motivation. And a lot of people chat about that in the terms of having a why for your goals or your reason behind wanting to achieve these things. And it's really, really crucial to take some time to sit down and figure out not only what your goals are for 2019, but your motivations for achieving those goals. Why is it important to you personally to be able to do that thing? And initially, you might get some superficial answers. For example, if you are working your business goals, the first why, for example, in increasing sales could be to get more money. But I want you to dig even deeper than that. If, for example, you did have a lot more money, why do you want that to happen? What are the things that that is going to mean for you? Is it because then you will have more time to spend with your family and you won't have to spend as much time away from work? Or does that mean being able to give back more to an organization that is near and dear to your heart, or have more time to volunteer, that kind of thing? So I really want you to take some time while you're setting your goals for 2019 to figure out your real, true, deep internal motivation for that, and then kind of create yourself, if that's what works for you, a vision board that includes your whys. I don't make a lot of picture vision boards. I am more of a journaler. I like to write, so I always have a list of goals going in my planner and my agenda and in my business books and that kind of thing, with checklists and deadlines to keep me motivated. So I guess that's another tip I can offer, is to set yourself a lot of mini goals and mini checklists so that you feel like you are accomplishing things. My cat's decided to join us. She's very, very snuggly. So every single week while I'm doing my weekly review with Brendon Burchard's High Performance Habit, I am asking myself these questions. And these are the questions that research has proven that the top performers in the world ask themselves on a daily basis as well. So, without further ado, let's get right into his 5 questions around raising necessity, and necessity being your reason why this needs to get done. So, number 1, I was emotionally committed to excellence today. And as you will see and discover, your why is always going to be attached to something emotional that is going to be the driving force for you. Number 2, I knew my why today and I worked for it. Number 3, I cared about serving others today. Karma is a real thing. Good people get good things that come back to them, and you really should base your goals and your day-to-day aspirations on finding ways to serve other people around you, to assist them with something, to teach them something, to give them a boost of self-confidence, whatever that looks like for you. Did you care about serving others today, or did you come from a place of selfishness? Something to ask yourself honestly at the end of every single day. Number 4, I hit my deadlines and I finished my duties today. So as I kind of referred to earlier, is really setting yourself some deadlines for your goals, some checklists, some things that need to be done at a certain date. Because most of us respond well to deadlines and even work better, if you will, under pressure. I know that I tend to do my best work when I throw a deadline out to the world and hold myself accountable to it, then I know that it's going to get done. So that is question number four. Question number five, I managed my self-talk today to stay on my A game. And I think that that is really, really important when it comes to someone who's an entrepreneur or works from home and doesn't have a boss who's expecting things of them. You really need to manage your self-talk. Don't get too negative on yourself, for one. Don't make excuses for yourself on why you don't need to get work done. Those are kind of self-talk things that can get in your way. And then again, the self-talk of comparing yourself to other people and that you're not good enough and that you don't deserve this thing. Manage your self-talk. Rewire that in your brain. As soon as you start to say things like that to yourself, mentally stop. Trigger yourself to switch your train of thought and start telling yourself some positive affirmations. So I hope that was a little bit helpful. That is the third out of six of the high performance habits that he has us review in our weekly checklist. If you want to see my video about seeking clarity or generating energy, I will link both of those videos below. That was week one and two. If you want to stick around and see what we have next week while we talk about increasing productivity, which I know is super, super important to so many of us, then be sure to subscribe, because that one will be coming to you next Sunday. I look forward to getting to know you all, and let me know in the comments what your why is, if you feel comfortable for sharing. When you have goals, set yourself some whys and focus on those on the days that you don't feel like getting up and doing the work that needs to be done. Remind yourself of your deep emotional why, and you will find that internal motivation just like the top performers in the world. Have a great week, everyone. Talk to you next Sunday.